What are we talking about today, good sir?
We're talking about Squid Games, man. I finally saw Squid Games. Also, you're on the, I can't see it. I just see the Netflix thing.
Oh, my fault.
So we're talking about Squid Games, late as fuck to the party, because in internet times, this shit happened 2 years ago.
Yeah, I think I checked it out. What was it, like 3 weeks ago? Like three or 4 weeks ago, whenever it, you know, it dropped and everybody was talking about it. And I told you about it, and you kind of linked to the party, so.
It's everywhere, man. It's all over my Instagram feed.
Mm-hmm.
Good Lord, I'm so tired of this fucking show.
In a good way or a bad way? Like, how do you feel about
it? Man, always. Always. In every way. All of them, Gohan. All of them.
Okay. I know, I personally liked it. It's... I like the show. I like what it did. It reminded me of a lot of, they have a few animes that have a similar premise, except they're not necessarily playing kids games. The thing with those is gambling. So they're just gambling. And if you lose, they, you know, they'll kill you and take you out. But none of them, from what I've seen, well, certain animes are good. They had a live action movie based on an anime that had, Michael Douglas in it. I watched it a few months back. Something similar, like I said, gambling and everything, and they kill people. But that wasn't as tense as some of the stuff that they had, you know, the people doing this.
Mm.
So how did you feel, like, about the story and about how things went? And did you like it, hate it? I mean, you said you're feeling everything, so.
Let me talk about the story first. After finish, I had to binge watch it. So I binge watched it, like, for past 2 days.
Mm-hmm.
There were parts where it was just like, plot hole. You know what I mean? I don't like that.
Mm-hmm.
So overall, the story is really fucking depressing. It's really depressing.
Oh yeah.
Like I didn't really like that part of it. I thought it would be like, I thought I would be happier with it, but it's, okay. I'm sorry. I'm not making any sense right now. Overall, I didn't really like it because there was just so much death in it. You know, it's so much dying. I don't know what the fuck it is about, like, America and the rest of the world, the fascination with death. It fucking exudes me. I can't figure out why people love shit like this.
Mm.
Like, they love either like murder or death. You know what I mean?
Mm.
There was nothing but murdering in this motherfucker. Like, nothing but, like, how can we find new ways to kill people? And it's just like, I'm not a fan of that, you know? Mm-hmm. Mostly because this is all I've been seeing recently, is just like, how can we find ways to just murder and kill people and death? And not just in this show, but in every other show that is out right now. It's just like, I don't know. I kind of get tired of it. Like, and then the greed thing. And I know, mm-hmm. right? It's there's a part of it that's like, ooh, you know, this is interesting.
Mm-hmm.
None of this shit was dramatic to me. The people that I kind of cared about ended up dying, which I knew that was going to happen. But it's just like, after about 4 or 5 episodes, I'm like, it's just too much death in it. I'm kind of done.
Okay, so you zoned out.
Yeah, because there's, you know, there's really no humanity in it at all.
No, definitely isn't. I mean, it's the one thing I do like about it is yeah, it's a negative show. And for the longest time, like, I don't know if you know the history behind the show, but I remember reading an article that talked about it where before it got to Netflix, they were trying to shop it around to different services and stuff. Before mm-hmm. they, you know, made it, essentially.
The guy sold his laptop and stuff, and it finally got picked up. Yeah.
Yeah. But, like, nobody wanted to pick it up because they saw the same thing that you said. They saw it was too violent. It wasn't nothing really to it besides just that. But then somebody picked it up, and somehow it got made, and they brought it over here for Netflix. But yeah. I guess that's the appeal. I mean, it's appealing to people who go watch the Saw movies and stuff like that. The story is what I like.
And Purge and shit like that. Yeah.
Like, I like the story behind the main character more so than the killing. Because the killing ain't really they didn't really do anything death wise that nothing else has ever have ever done. They weren't, it wasn't that brutal, but no. I like the, you know, the characters, like the main character story from where he was being like a loser asshole to being like at the end to where he had money and didn't even spend it. So to me, I'm like, you're just invalidating your reason for getting that money. You let all of that, all those people sacrifices go in vain or whatever. And you have this money and you're not even, you know, using it. So I like that. I mean, it makes me interested to see where they're going to take season two based on how they ended season one.
Man, that shit could have ended in one season. One fucking, that's all I needed. All I needed was one season. I don't want to see no more of this shit. And like, so I know that they didn't, like, the deaths weren't brutal, but it was just so many. Like, 456 motherfuckers was in there. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. That's a lot of fucking killing. That means if it's movie accurate, I didn't see a motherfucker get murdered. Like, 456 murders or 455. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I don't need to see them. I'm good.
The only thing they could do is just make different traps or make different games or whatever. But
I'll say this, coming from somebody that almost fucking died himself, I don't want to see no more death. You know what I mean? I don't even want this shit to be on my radar. You know what I mean? And I know it's not me, right? But there's a part that when I look at society that hasn't been through shit, you know what I'm saying? Mm. That hasn't been like through a lot of shit.
Close to death or accepted that they were going to die, but then they didn't.
They fetishized, like, this shit is like a fetish. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like seeing a bunch of people get murdered and like how people are so brutal and how there's no humanity in these people and how humanity leaves them over time and how they will do anything for money. And it's just like, I'm good. Already, like the world as it is right now is already just as disgusting as this.
Yeah.
I don't need to see it in a visual art form, like in movie form or TV form. And I know that people out there like it, right? And it's just entertainment and there's, you know, you're not supposed to take it seriously.
Can't help but take it seriously because
Yeah. I don't like, it's not for me. That's all I'm saying. It's not really for me, even though I watched the whole thing. The fucking ending pissed me off, dog. Like, it made me so, like, I understood how he was upset and he didn't want to take the money or use the money. But a lot of that shit went unanswered.
Yeah.
And I know why, because it was set it up for a second season. But it's just like, dude, motherfucker, like, you didn't, that's a lot of shit you didn't do. Like, for me, when he was talking about all that bullshit and if we end it now, like the people that died and blah, blah, blah. Like he said all these things. He saw it. At the same time, you already made a promise to that chick to take care of her son. What about all, like, fine. How about you take the money? Because this is what I thought he was going to do. I thought he was going to take the money and start dishing it out to all the people in his team.
That's what I thought too. Yeah. Like he would, you know, in their stead, since they weren't there to do it, give the money to their families or whatever.
I thought he would find a way to get that girl's parents out of North Korea and get their family together. But now he's like, here, he pawned off a kid to this old woman and gave him a bunch of money. Did you tell that old woman what happened to her son? No. Mm-hmm. Did you tell that kid what happened to her sister? Probably not. You know what I mean? You just took him out. You found a way to take him out of orphanage. I don't know how you did that shit. Just taking a fucking kid out of an orphanage and then gave a shit ton of money with no instructions to this woman.
Yeah.
What is she supposed to do?
And that's, she a lot was of an older money. Woman too, who's probably won't, or she won't outlive that kid. So like, she's going to die in like the next few years and the kid's going to be like, what, 15, 20 or whatever. Yeah.
I mean, they didn't do anything, right? That didn't fucking help. So, what's the other thing? Shit. You didn't give no money to. Did you get that woman's her house back? Remember, because homeboy put his mom's house up for collateral and lost that shit.
Mm-hmm.
That's why the Korean version of the IRS was coming after his ass. It's like, did you pay her house off? No. He told you all this shit, right? He told you the issues that he was having. He didn't even try to correct it with the money he had. I mean, his mom died, so I can understand that. I'd be depressed too. But it's like, there's a lot of shit that, you know, that went unresolved. The reason why you went there in the first place was so that way you can fix your mom and
get money for your kid.
Show that you was rich enough to get your kid back. And you own a fucking tarmac. Like, get the fuck on a plane, bro. Mm-hmm. Fuck that shit. I would have, even better, like, seeing that dude slap that other dude, I'd have just kept on walking. Fuck it. I'd have just kept, mm-hmm. Kept on walking. That would have been so much better.
Yeah.
Or at least, when you at the point where he takes the phone call, they just answer.
Mm-hmm.
Right? But he don't say nothing. And then just end it. Just end it with him taking the phone call, right?
Yeah.
Just end it. You don't need to show, oh, fuck it, I'm going to come for you, motherfucker. No.
Why? You can't, yeah.
you just got out of that. Why are you going back? That's stupid, right?
Yeah.
Unless I originally thought that he was going to go back to play another game because
that's
he
what
didn't
I
have
thought.
Anything left.
That's what I thought, too. I thought that he was going to be like, oh, maybe he's addicted to the stuff, just like with the old man where he wanted to do it. You know? So I thought it was going to be something like that, where it's like, okay, now that you've essentially lived life, you know, with that, that's all you think about, that adrenaline rush, that risking your life, you know, and death and all that shit. Like I thought he would be addicted to that, and that's why he would go back. The ending reminded me of, have you ever seen the Escape Room movie?
Uh-uh.
That's exactly how the name implies, a bunch of people trapped in an escape room.
It's just like Saw, but it's escape room and it kills you.
Yeah. You got to figure out the puzzles and shit. But at the end of that movie, they had the main character chick who did something similar where it was she got out and I want to say somebody else got out. And they got away with their lives. They got out and was cool. You know, they didn't win no money like this guy did. But but in her mind, it was like, oh, they're wrong and evil. I want to get back at them. And she she had to convince the other guy. The other guy was like, no, I don't want to, you know, remember any of that shit. I just want to live my life and be fine. Like, fuck them. I don't care. You know, but she just couldn't let it go and drug him back into chasing after these people, just like he did at the end of Squid Games.
It's stupid. I feel like the story isn't strong enough to lead up to that point, right?
Yeah.
Like, his whole thing was leaving twice. He tried to leave twice.
Mm-hmm. And then the moment he got out, he wanted to go back.
Yeah, it doesn't make sense for him to go back and try to fight that. You saw how difficult it was to fight it in the first place. Why would you go back? Only to make a season two. Your overall thing was to get your child back. You need to go worry about that shit.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, there's nothing else for you. And then the other thing that was confusing, how the fuck did a contestant end up becoming the face man, right? The front man.
Mm.
Like the cop's brother. That was a weird, weak ass story too, because that led nowhere.
Yeah.
Like the cop went in, figured out all this shit, figured out they was harvesting organs, killed a dude, got away, got to an island, tried to send some shit off, but I don't know if it worked or not, because he basically said there's no signal here. So
yeah, I'm assuming,
you know, and didn't work. And then he sees his brother, and then his brother shoots him and he falls into the ocean. Now, the only thing that would probably happen is in season two, he would probably come back, because he shot him in the arm. It wasn't a death blow and he fell into the ocean. Doesn't necessarily mean that he died. He didn't hit rocks. You don't see the body. But the overall idea was that kind of went nowhere. And then you get this left with this answer is, how did a contestant who won one game out of however many games have been played become a front man for the entire show?
Yeah.
I actually thought they were, that when he made the phone call, I thought that they was going to offer him that job.
Yeah. Like I was thinking something similar. Even when he shot him, I thought, at least what my interpretation of that was, that he didn't shoot him to kill him, that he shot him to save him. Because if he didn't do nothing, the guards would have shot and killed him. So
saw his face.
Yeah. So it's like, I figured he shot him to let everybody else believe that he died when he really didn't. So, but yeah, I mean, I figured maybe he had the same kind of thing as the main guy at the end, except where instead of going after them, he agreed with the old man and his way of thinking and philosophy or whatever. I don't know if that's going to be a thing in season two. I mean, I'm assuming it is. because they didn't go anywhere with it. But that's what I thought. But then again, who knows what they're gonna do.
Also, I thought this shit was sponsored by PlayStation, bro. Like, it was so
all the colors
weird. Mm. No, all the fucking symbols. Like, it was so weird seeing like a group of people with those masks on, with triangles and squares and shit. It looked like a fucking cutscene in a Last of Us video. Yeah, I was like, what the hell? It looks like a PlayStation ad. The whole thing. It's like, I kept imagining like boom, like to pop up on the screen with the fucking PlayStation logo. But the other part that I didn't like was the VIPs.
Yeah, I didn't like that part either. That you could have cut that whole segment out.
That whole thing. I didn't need VIPs. This could have been a digital thing, a digital only thing where yep. like people online can see it.
Yeah.
In a certain server.
That's where I thought they were gonna go with, but yeah, I didn't like that whole segment at all either. Like, it's
because the dialogue was shitty. The dialogue yeah. was really shitty. It was nothing but 69 jokes all the time. And I was like, mm-hmm. Unless you're trying to make American sound retarded, you know what I mean? Yeah. I guess you can go that route. But he was like, oh fuck him, man. Like, god dang it. He was like, why? What's wrong? I bet $1 million on him. Why? Because 69.
Yeah, it was.
It's a beautiful number. And then he did it again. It was like, why 96? Because if I can't have 69, I was like, ugh. And then yeah. when he tried to take homeboy to the back room, he was like, oh, you're going to get that 69? And it's like, mm-hmm. fuck, dude, this same shitty joke over and yeah. over and over again. Come on, man. It's not landing.
They lost
none of
that
shit made sense.
Yeah, they lost me with that whole segment. Like, I was digging the intrigue. I wanted to know more about the people putting them there, the face man. And that's when it happened. Like, when the cop was looking around for dirt and figuring shit out, that was cool. And then they introduced that part with the VIPs. And it's just like, to me, it took me out of what I came here for, which was the intrigue of who these people are that's kidnapping yeah. these people. And yeah. the contestants in the games, going through the games and stuff, like the glass one right there. You know, it's like it kept jumping back out of that. And every second that I was there, I was like, why can't we watch the other shit? You know?
That middle, that VIP part, I think it would have been better if they didn't say that much.
Yeah.
Like if they were almost just as quiet, because they're giving away a lot of information by using, like, one, you're using your real voice, you don't have any voice modulation on it. And two, it's just like their nonchalantness and like yeah. it was just like shitty jokes. It just didn't seem like somebody who would have a lot of money. You know, they yeah. didn't have that aura around them. It's just
maybe it just dropped the wrong way. Yeah, maybe they just dropped the ball with it, because maybe that's what they were going for. Like, if you're so rich, nothing matters. But that didn't come across the screen to me. So something.
No. You have to give them more dialogue than that. So, yeah. Like a little bit more than that. It was an old movie a long time ago. They did it on there. It was damn near this exact same thing. I think it was called The Island. It's where they basically drug a bunch of contestants and put them on an island, and they had to manhunt each other. And while they were on the island, there were some very, very, like, rich English people. And they would talk and, like, be, like, very, not fancy, but, like, what do you call it?
Posh, stuck up.
Posh.
British.
Yeah. Like, very, yeah. Yeah, they'd be very posh, like, drinking their martinis and shit and, like, talking extremely proper. It felt like that. It felt like they were, like, upper echelon, and then you had commoners fucking fighting for their lives. That one felt like even the poshness felt more like succinct with the whole thing, because it they seemed like extremely rich, powerful people playing with the lives of like fucking pawns or some shit, and they had masks and shit too. It was again, oh shit, it was just like this, but an English version. Except for the people here aren't posh. They're fucking dumbasses. They're immature. And I guess that's like a cool play on it, because everyone else is like the people who were hosting the game were like have more maturity than the people, like the VIPs. But that's why it fell short for me. It's because I seen I've seen it done better in other shows and other movies a long time ago.
Yeah, it makes sense. Yeah. I loved it for what it was. I mean, it was negative and all that stuff, but I still, I can watch that stuff and not be turned off completely. But, you know, as long as you're telling me some kind of story, or it's the same thing with like watching medical documentaries. Most people don't like watching surgeries and shit because they get turned off or they get squeamish. And me, I'm fascinated by that shit. I will watch somebody get cut open and be just fine and sleep fine the next day.
Yeah, but not me. I don't know, like seeing people as like meat sacks, which technically that's what we are. I don't know, like anything that dehumanizes a person, it gets me, because like I'm really fascinated with the humanity in people. Like that's what I look for, not the violence, because I see violence all the time. I don't need to see more of it.
I get you.
And I think that's what, I'm not really getting desensitized to it. I think I'm getting more sensitive to it. Because it happens so frequently in the world, in our society, and people, and like this whole thing was, life doesn't matter, murder doesn't matter, killing is easy, and then at the very end, the old man dying peacefully, like even that was fucking depressing. And when he said that, what's the two things in common that a rich person who has more money than what he can do with and a poor person that doesn't have a penny to his name have in common? And the first thing I thought of was like, they both die in the end. Like that's the first thing like I thought of. But what he said was like, they believe that life itself, like their quality of life doesn't change or some shit like that. It was something like that. It was like where when you're rich, you've done everything and then life is boring. But when you're poor, you can't do anything and life is boring. And it's just like, it kind of, that was a hit or miss for me too. It's like, that's, if I was fucking rich, you still have the ability to do a lot of shit, and quality of life does change. And there's so much stuff in the world to experience. You know what I mean? Yeah. And I think you have a lot more time to take a lot of shit to appreciation. But if you've done everything, you know what I'm saying, with your trillions of dollars, it's like the people that's in your life is supposed to be better, and he said that, like the friends and stuff like that, but that doesn't change. You know what I'm saying? When you get money, you get friends, you still have friends, but that still doesn't change shit. But the whole dying part, I think that would have been a better you know, idea to say, because that's all you see in the entire thing is different ways to die. Like, the mom got sick and died of diabetes, and he found her at the house. You know, like, that dude died in the hospital bed. These motherfuckers got shot, stabbed, fucking failed to their death, incapacitated, choked out. It was just, I don't know, it was just a killing porn. That's all it was. I guess,
Mm, I get you. And that's what draws people into, you know, watching this kind of sort of stuff. So it's okay if you just don't feel that way. It's the way it is. Yeah. It's like we was talking earlier about football and all of that. A lot of people are into that kind of stuff for those reasons. Yeah. Us, we're not. So,
yeah,
you know, it's the same thing. We're fascinated with aggression and death and all that stuff. You know, nobody who likes this show would be in one of these games. You know, they wouldn't want to go through all this shit, but it is what it is.
But us as a society, we are VIP watching this shit, if you think about it.
Yeah. That's where I thought they were going to go with it. You know, like some kind of meta commentary on, you know, watching people or fascinated by watching other people go through life and death.
They didn't say that.
You know, that's where I thought they were going to go with that old man, but they didn't.
I know.
But, you know.
I mean, and that's what I mean, is like the story is like this, what carries the story is the death. Mm. It's not the story itself, because the story itself is kind of vague. You know, it really isn't a story, because nothing resolves itself. And I think that's the part that got me the most, was that all of this technically was for nothing. Right.
Yeah.
Because You don't see him pay his bookie back. You don't see him pay off his debt. You know, you. I mean, of course it's implied, but you don't see him really take care of the shit that he promised to other people. So the premise of it, like the resolution of a happy ending for anybody in here isn't there. And the only thing that carried it was the games and people dying from place to place. And that's what it felt like. It felt like I was a VIP watching this shit, watching just the games. And the story of each individual person didn't matter in the end. And that's, I think that's what disappointed me the most, because I went into it looking for a really good story. And what everyone is saying, even when I'm like look on Instagram and like hear people talk, like they're talking about just the games. They got memes of the little fucking honeycomb shit. They got like the memes of this. I seen somebody in Animal Crossing make this scene in Animal Crossing.
Wow.
It was fucking dope. I was like, wow, that's very creative that they made that shit. But that's what I look at. It's like, okay, yeah, that's all you care about. Right. But you didn't care about the story and care about plot devices, none of that shit. It's like, yeah. So for me, it's like, this is cool. And I watched it. I watched the whole thing so I can have an opinion on it. But I can't, this isn't prevalent for me.
So yeah, I get you. You couldn't fully get behind it. But the last thing, let me ask you, what did you think about the one game that they did? Because it was the biggest game that resonated with me. And I'm assuming that's what they wanted for the show. What did you think about the one game where they had to betray each other? Where they had to play marbles?
What did I think about it?
Yeah. Because that was something that I guess it didn't have any overarching depth, but, you know, I thought it was done very well.
I didn't.
Well,
I mean, like the idea of them like trying to choose like the better teammate, I think that, like psychologically, that's that was nice because it was the same thing like for tug of war. They're trying to find the best person to play with. And in the Marvel game, they're trying to find, again, the best person to play with. So, yeah, the matchup was done extremely well. You know me, I'm going to turn something into race. The only Indian guy, you had to kill that motherfucker off, man. Pissed me off. I'm like, this is the only brown-skinned motherfucker. I'm like, well, at least he made it to episode 5. Yeah, I can be thankful for that.
You had like 495 Asians or Koreans. Yeah, one Indian dude. He had to go.
Yep. He had to go. I will say that it was fucked up how he was tricking that dude.
It was.
But he knew the whole time. I was like, oh shit, that's kind of clean.
The part that I found messed up is when he ripped his shirt off and was like, oh, I'm just gonna make you a thing, and he did it. And then the guy
I didn't like that.
I ain't like that either. I was like, that's so shitty.
Like, the reason I didn't like that was because that was poor writing to me.
And what
it was really... So, in a way that... If I was in that life or death situation, trusting anybody...
Yeah.
First thing, he said that he would give him that marble to hold on to for safekeeping. And I never saw him put it in his hand.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, that's plot hole number one.
Yeah, red flag, yeah.
Yeah. And if I was in that situation, I'd have been like, okay, cool. Give me the marble. Because you already got all the fucking marbles. You just need to fucking put it in my hand. If for safekeeping, just give it to me. There's no reason for you not to, right?
Yeah.
So that upset me. And because the whole thing is supposed to be considered fair, right? If this is fair... And this guy was watching the whole fucking time, like the guy behind the mask. If you win said marbles, these are your marbles. You can't steal marbles.
I get what you're saying,
If that's the case, then that means you could have went around to other people and killed them and just took 10 marbles and added it to yours and then gave it to a fucking person.
I get you.
Right? Because they didn't really specify those. They weren't detailed with those rules. So, like, that kind of irritated me because, like, those rules need to be set in stone to where these specific things could happen and couldn't happen because it didn't make sense for the other games to be like that. Well, you can do whatever, right?
Yeah, they were very sticking to the rules and all that stuff. You had to do it by the letter. Yeah.
Yeah. So it's like, okay, if you take 10 or 20 marbles total and then give it to a person, you're in. When he didn't give him the marble, I was like, how did the guy not notice that he didn't get his fucking marble? Mm. So I looked past that. And then he was like, go around and it's not safe to keep these marbles. I was like, why is it not safe? Mm-hmm. Nobody in here is being violent. Nobody in here is running to other people. So it is safe to keep the marbles. Because the only person that you're playing against is you, nigga. Like, that line of reasoning didn't make sense. So, and then the other thing is that when he put the shit down on the ground and then covered it with a jacket, I'm like, why are you even doing that? Mm-hmm. Why don't you put it in your pocket?
Yeah, you could just, you got pockets, you got your hands, you just had to keep them on you, yeah.
So as soon as he covered it, I was like, that's a fucking magic trick right there, nigga. Don't believe that shit. That's stupid. So he did that. Replaced the shit with rocks. And I'm thinking, the entire time you playing, you can't see this nigga fucking grabbing rocks over there? Mm-hmm. It's like the guy had no peripheral vision, none of that shit. So for you're me, saying
they made the Indian guy stupid in order to make their scene work.
And he wasn't stupid.
Yeah.
At no point in time did he show any kind of stupidity. You know what I mean? Well, it's like, it's maybe innocence.
Yeah, I would say gullible, but I
wouldn't say gullible, but like not that fucking gullible to where he can't see what's going on. He even questioned him when he was like, when he started begging. Mm. And at that point, it's like, look, man, no, you got a family too. Mm-hmm. You got fucking wife and kids. I wanted him to make it all the way through to the end more than I wanted the other dude to make it. But I kind of saw where it was going during the honeycomb issue. Where he remembered exactly what was going on, and he said, we need to all pick different shapes and shit. And the main character looked at him, and he knew that he was something was weird about it. He knew it, but he couldn't put his finger on it, and he was like, well, I did pick the umbrella. It's like, no, don't do that. You knew something was wrong when he asked you.
Yeah, he's willing to do anything to survive,
Yeah. So at that point, I kind of figured that they would have that character kind of be like the villain, like turn the villain like eventually on. So it was a lot of it was predictable. I will say this. The one thing that the other thing that disappointed me was one of the games.
Which one?
The main guy, the glass.
Oh, the one. And
there was something that really got to me. They was talking about pane glass versus plexiglass. Or however, whatever kind of glass it was.
Tempered glass versus...
tempered glass, yeah. Now, I was thinking, he's the very last one, and they kept showing pictures, like they kept showing their feet when they took the shoes off. I thought he was going to be at the back, tying all the shoes together and like putting them around his neck and taking the shoes with him, right?
Why would he take the shoes with him?
Why would he take it with him? I thought that towards the end... when they couldn't figure out which glass is which, he would take shoes and throw them into the glass to get the glass to break. If the glass broke, you know what's the next one. Yeah. So I that's all he had to do. So
yeah, but would shoes be enough to break a pane of glass though?
If they're heavy enough, if you take the shoes and they all had laces and you tie them together. Right, and you tie multiple shoes towards the end,
one, like, tie,
and you swing that shit. Yeah, you just swing it. Like, you can just swing it like a little ram or whatever, and try to strike the glass to make it break.
That's it. I get you. I was thinking taking one shoe and just throw it at it.
Yeah, I mean either one, like you know, just like whichever is heavier that would make glass break. It's like I would have thought of some shit like that to do.
Yeah.
Towards the end, when he was like, I can hear the glass. I was like, you have a vest with plastic on it. Take your vest off and fucking hit the glass to see if it makes a sound. Mm-hmm. Why do you need another marble?
Or take off your vest and you know, because it has the zipper part in it.
Has a zipper on it.
Just smack that, you know, the metal on the glass and break it that way.
Like stuff like that was like like plot holes that it was like, eh, I can't get past that. And I know I'm nitpicking, but in a game that's life and death, you would think of this kind of shit.
People would be thinking outside the box.
Yes. And that's what I wanted more. I wanted more people to think outside the box than for it to be extremely obvious.
Mm. Yeah. Yeah, it was that. It was very, I'm not going to say formulaic, but once you, they didn't try to do any twists. You know, there was no M. Night Shyamalan twist to one of the games or something like that. It's just,
well, except for the honeycomb one, that I think that was like the biggest twist. It's like, oh shit, I can just lick the back of it. Like that was smart. I didn't even think of that. I was like, oh, okay, cool. Mm. That makes sense.
Yeah.
But yeah, everything else, eh.
All right. Well, it is what it is, I guess. It can't please anybody. But I have there's like off camera, you know, we're gonna talk about a couple different animes that have a similar presence. That kind of do it a little bit better than how they did it. You know, I can recommend. So if you get bored watching some stuff, you can watch those and let me know how you think.
Man, Eden of the East is so fucking good. That was way better. Like, that's the kind of shit I'm talking about. Like, I like that shit. If Eden of the East had a lot of death in it, this would have, like, it would have beat this. You know what I mean?
Nope. All right, YouTube, that's what we had to say about Squid Games here. If you guys want us to check out any other Korean TV show or whatever, let us know down in the comments.
How did y'all feel? I want to know that. What did y'all like about Squid Games? That's really what I want to know. Like, was the story good, or was it just like the killing porn that you were interested in?
Mm-hmm. You want to know if people are just horny for murder, huh?
Yep, that's what I want to know. I want to know... If you watched it, which everyone pretty much did, what kind of person are you? Are you a psychotic motherfucker that enjoys fucking pain and death and shit like that? Or are you just like me? It's like, you know, you're looking for a good story and, you know, all the other stuff is just dressing.
All right, YouTube, let us know down in the comments below, one way or the other. We will see you guys in the next one. Peace out.